that one.
Yes.
Was that it?
No. No.
Devin.
No shot. No shot.
Hold up.
Devin.
Oh. Devin.
Don't lose him. Devin. Oh my gosh.
Hey, folks, what's going on? Welcome back to the Fishing and Norm YouTube channel. Guys, comment is popping up down below. So go ahead, hit the subscribe button, hit the bell, leave a comment down below. For your chance to be next video's comment of the day. Guys, we're the fastest growing fishing channel on YouTube right now, so thank you guys so much for that. But today, we are here at Bass Pro Shops, and we are doing something that you guys have been requesting in the comments down below for like years now, and it's fly fishing. I've just been so scared to take on fly fishing by myself because I have no clue how to do it. It's like a foreign art to me.
Jesus Christ.
And also for the first time on this channel, we have Alex Blackwell.
We're trying to get you a fly rod today so that maybe, just maybe, you start to fall in love with the sport.
The bait casters and spinning are so easy, you know what I mean? I feel like fly fishing is gonna be so hard.
Well, hey, cripple yourself a little bit and, yeah, you know, have some fun with it. It can be really rewarding, and I think that anybody that's gotten into fly fishing over the last 10 years or so in our generation can tell you it's fun. But it is also challenging, so it's gonna be interesting to see how bait casting conventional guy takes on the fly game and how quickly he learns it.
Everything I have heard from people who go fly fishing is once they go fly fishing, they never go back. You know, like they never want to throw a spinning rod and a bait caster anymore. It's like once you catch one on the fly, it's so much more complicated and so much more fun that nobody picks this stuff up anymore. That's what I'm worried about. I don't want to like only be a fly fishing channel, guys. I want to be able to pick up the bait caster
too. Man, listen, I'm not a fly or die kind of guy. I'm a tug is the drug. Come on, let's get tight. I mean, I still throw conventional. I still throw spin, but it's fun to target the fish with a fly rod.
So it's Devin and I's first time ever fly fishing, which is going to be absolutely awesome. And Blackwell is like an experienced fly fisherman.
Sensei.
We are the Padawans today to the Jedi. 5,000 likes, we'll do a 1v1v1 fly fishing challenge. This is like the video where we learn how to fly fish. But once I master it today in like 20 minutes, we'll do a 1v1v1 challenge next. 5,000 likes.
We'll see about that.
Yeah.
We'll see. Let's go.
Blackwell's going to smoke us. I heard like fly fishing is kind of like the motion of the ocean type thing. You know what I mean?
It's all about flow, patience, rhythm. So you can dance.
Oh,
you can
fly. I can't dance. I can't dance. The crazy thing is, I'm pretty sure I was in here like 6 months ago and I saw like a rod for $900. And my most expensive rod to date now was like $200-$300 for bass fishing. So I know fly fishing gets super, super expensive. I think it's gonna be a ton of fun today.
First things first, right? It's fly line. These are starter fly lines.
They're not good.
They're not great. I like a smoother fly line, so I end up spending like $90 on my fly line. But that line's gonna last you a year or two. It's not like braid, where like you have to replace it. Next thing is leader selection. You're fishing for bass. They've got some serrated teeth, so 20 pound. If you like to use like 20 pound fluoro.
This is so confusing for me right now. I know everybody watching too is like, what is going on?
Which is why it's hard to get into it without knowing anything. You're kind of at a disadvantage, so.
Because if it wasn't for you, we would be trying to learn it ourselves and we would ruin everybody's fly fishing experience. We'd be out there saying, yeah, throw this. And it would be completely backwards.
So now you got three different leader selections and we're ranging from 20 to 10 pounds.
Oh, you even got the flies ready.
I even grabbed some flies. These are actually like my favorite bass flies. And I brought some other ones for you, but these are Betts Fancy Grade Poppers.
We do love the popper action.
And that way you can see the strike, which everybody loves.
Yeah.
And you immediately know when to set the hook. And it's not some, you know, out of the ordinary thought process of, hey, do I actually have a fish or am I on weeds?
How easy is it to like flip in smaller areas with fly rods? Or do you actually have to?
For the most part, you have to cast.
I don't know anything about it. They probably all just cringed when we said flip a fly.
I'll show you a cast that might work for that. It's called a roll cast.
Today, we're not just beginner fly fishermen. We're gonna be pros by the end of the day. By the end of this video, I'm gonna be able to cast a fly all the way across the river and catch big trout here in Florida, so.
You know what this is videos like? It's literally like when we took him bass fishing, but now we're safe.
Yeah.
Like literally.
That was the best analogy I've ever heard.
Literally.
I literally feel like I'm fishing for the first time today. This is gonna be super cool. Wait, I wanna look at all the flies.
Yeah. Oh, bug poppers.
Yes, sir.
Those look like you can throw those on bait casters too.
Exactly. There's some big boys.
It's tied by hand. True. So this is not like, it's plastic molded in a factory overseas or here in the States. It is hand tied. That's like actual cork that's been placed onto a hook. All those little legs and everything like that. It's not by machine, it's all by hand.
That's crazy. I like that, made with love.
Yep, so I would do these, and I mean, that's gonna set you up for bass fishing for a while until you come back here and you've lost all those in trees.
Yeah, give it like 30 minutes.
It gets a little complicated, but for bass fishermen, as yourselves, poppers are the way to go. No questions asked.
I know I saw a fly mouse in like some store at one point in time. I want a mouse.
It's like a little hedgehog mouse thing.
Can we use this to catch bass today?
Yes, and you can also use this. What does that look like?
Well, it looks like a jig, first off.
But it also looks like the little arts and crafts you would get at Walmart.
Yeah.
You know, like the little twisty things.
The best way to describe what this probably looks like is more like a Senko. So it's weighted on the front, kind of like a Texas rig.
Okay.
And it's weedless too. Check that out.
Oh, that's sweet.
Look at that.
Bro, fly fishing makes so many more cool lures than like normal fishing, dude.
But it's not my favorite style. I like those poppers, and so I gave you the juice before, you know, you got a little creative.
Blackwell has no clue what he got himself into. He was like, yeah, I'll teach these guys how to fly fish. He put us on all of the sauce, the best combos, best lures, best everything, and I see a bumblebee and I go crazy.
Like, look at that though, it's a little bumblebee. These things are like $9 a piece,
and I'm probably gonna buy a lot of them because they all look so cool.
The whole ecosystem in here, bro, look at that. It's like a little cricket. What is that thing? Is that like a dragonfly without wings?
You know they had moths in here?
There's so many like crazy little things in here, like as small as like this little worm. I don't know if like an 8-pound bass would even come after something. Dude, there's ladybugs in here. Dude, that's gotta be the world's smallest fishing lure. Look at this, Blackwell, there's a ladybug.
Oh no, there's tinier.
They make them smaller than that?
Yeah, they're called midges.
Guys, there's also a ton of fishing reels in here, fly fishing reels, but from my understanding, fly fishing, you don't actually use the reel, you hand the line, so is the reel less important than the rod?
In my opinion, it is, but it depends on how big of a fish you get on. Because as soon as you start fighting fish that are in that 5, 10, 20 pound range, they will pull all that line out of your hands and you'll end up getting on the reel. And so if you're fighting big fish, you want a good drag system. So that 8-weight that you got, I've caught a 50 pound tarpon on an 8-weight.
What?
Yeah, it's stupid.
How long did that take to?
45 minutes.
Oh, I don't even know what to say to that.
I got you a little cup to start with.
Okay.
Your ladybug's in there. There's two of the little worms.
I think those would be fire.
And then I did throw in the mouse pattern for you.
It's just gonna be a miracle today if our lure hits the water, honestly. Let's be honest here. We're buying all this stuff and we're not even gonna, it's all gonna go into the trees. I think we got all of our fly fishing stuff. My first time ever fly fishing, my first fly fishing rod and reel.
Yeah, we're gonna go ahead and check all this stuff out and we'll see you guys at the pond.
All right, guys, we're here at the pond, actually, where we caught, like, the 9-pounder on the Dude Perfect combo, and also, Zay caught his first bass over there, second cast on the bait caster, 5.5-pounder.
So, we have our $170 fly fishing kit here. We ended up spending, I think it was, what, $290?
$290,
$290, yeah. So, basically, like, a $300 challenge. I think it's all going to be worth. So, we have our, I have no clue what I'm talking about when it comes to this stuff, guys, but we have the Crosswater. And I guess what you do with this is you put flies on it and you go fishing.
How do you do this?
I've already broken it.
That's it.
Sweet.
There's your line, so you can start putting it through the guides. I don't want to do everything for you.
I feel like you're my dad right now.
I wasn't paying attention. Can you restart from the top?
What are you doing? What if you cast and I just reel it in?
Do you want me to hold your hand while you shit too?
Kind of.
So this is how I always kind of start off tightening drag. You want to be able to pull line out with ease. And then so that's pretty easy to go ahead and pull line out. I mean, with fly casting, right, the line's actually weighted. So this green line that you've got right here, this is weight. That means that when you're throwing, you're actually throwing mainly the line. The line's loading
also
up.
Also, it doesn't really matter how much the lure weighs.
So the heavier the lure, the harder it is going to be to cast. And that's why I was like, let's go with a heavier rod for you, because you're going to want to do that. But a light lure like that worm that you picked out would be a great one to start off with.
So we have a lot of things here that we can choose from.
We've been catching them on the Lunker Logs, and that kind of looks similar. It's like has like a little jig skirt right here, and it's like this little purple tail. So we're gonna go ahead and try starting
with this thing. I feel like this could get some bites, and then maybe later we'll go to like top water with like the bumblebee.
We need practice. Practice makes perfect.
So, all right. So first things first, you're gonna want to pull out some line. I like somewhere between 10 and 20 foot to start. So this is what I want you to do. I want you to take your rod like this.
Okay.
I want you to put your finger right here, and I want you to come back and throw it forward. And just get comfortable with this motion. Just this motion, that's it. And you can go ahead and just watch that cast on the back. Think of it as like a C. And that C will go ahead and fold on out. As it starts to fold, as you're casting backwards, that's when you start to push forward. So it basically takes that line, starts to move it forward, and you're gonna get that same effect on the front hand cast. It's gonna be that C, and then as it starts to lay out, that's when you're gonna cast that. So, just so you can see it,
see
sounds
it.
Yeah,
so you see can it. See it. I see what you did there.
Easy enough, right? Just make the lure go far.
Okay, so finger here.
Yep.
Back.
So notice where your wrist was.
No, you don't want a flick of the wrist is what you're saying.
Basically, this is what I would do with a really good looking man, lady friend like I have. Here, 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 here. And I want you to watch that line. Watch the line instead of watching like the rod itself.
You're like this.
What's wrong with that?
Keep it a little closer. Be a little bit more relaxed, right?
Okay.
Pick it up. Let it go. So
why does it make it look so easy, dude?
All right. But you're gonna get this, seriously. It takes time, but finger as on the soon line. As you do, like, so right there, that would be ideal to start. So okay. from there, cast it forward. Okay. Pick it up again. And start really start to actually start getting that motion going.
Dang it!
I need a break. Let's teach Devin, and maybe Devin will like realize some things.
Honestly, maybe.
I just realized that was 45 minutes of me doing that, and I still feel like I actually had more confidence walking into it than now.
Of course, you just pick it up like without even. Honestly, I'm kind of impressed.
I'm gonna get this.
Honestly, not terrible. Like that could catch a fish. Like that's a great back cast right there. Solid. I think you're snapping it too much.
Where that line's laying out, it looks okay. Honestly stunning. Like 10 out of 10.
Don't hype me up. We're taking our time to learn this, and I can't wait to finally cast this fly into the water.
Sheesh!
I'm still kind of figuring it out.
That yes. one.
Yes.
Was that it?
No.
You got me so hot.
This is how he's looking right now. He's like, yes. Yes.
That's at least 10 foot.
You're at like a 4 out of 10, but a 4 out of 10 might catch a fish.
Yeah, still doable.
Yeah. Let's throw the worm on and let's put you in an area where you can actually cast.
All right, guys. So I have my fly fishing rod and reel here. Somehow, some way, if I get a bite, you're not supposed to set the hook. You like set the hook with your line by like pulling it like this. You would think you'd have to like use your rod, but the rod's really just to get the lure out there. And then the line is like what you pull to set the hook. I'm still learning. So any comments down below, guys, any tips and tricks for fly fishing, anything you see me doing wrong, just let me know from my experienced fly fisherman out there. But all right, so. Hey, dude, I'm in there, bro.
Right where you blew up, dude.
Yeah, I know. Like, that was right where I was aiming. I feel so proud of myself for casting in the right area.
Guys, we have done so many dumb challenges on, like, you know, kiddie poles.
And I'm telling you right now, I mean, look at this. I don't even know what to do. So I have a little bit of line out, put it in my hand, whip it back, whip it forward, whip it. It's going to drive me insane. You guys wanted the fly fishing content that you kept on asking me, so here it is. Oh, dude, I'm about to go crazy.
Okay, it's in the water.
It maybe only went about 2 inches in the water, but this is progress, guys. We literally caught a 5-pounder on a hot dog. Like, but this is next level tough. Uh-oh, my line's wrapped on a stick.
Oh,
dude. Let's go. Dude, Blackwell, I just casted it like 5 foot in the water, bro. He thought we had a fish on. My lure hit the water. Dude, we're leaving it there. This is going to be like a 30-minute cast right here. Yes. I'm going to get even a little bit more line out.
We're prepping for a long cast, guys. The longest cast, actually, in history of Fishing with Norm. All right.
Back. Forward. Back. Forward. Back. Dude, I'm getting the hang of it. The only problem is my line is all knotted.
Let's go.
Oh,
dude.
It's out there. We are in the strike zone right now. Oh my gosh. Dude, I'm casting it further than you. Basically, I just threw it out there like 7 foot. No big deal, but you could say that I've got it down now.
You make it look so easy.
I try not to.
Devin.
What?
Devin.
No shot.
Hold up. Oh no, my rod's in the stream.
What'd you do?
I don't know how to. All right, so I don't reel, right? Wait, instruct me.
Trip, man.
Oh, geez, he's right there. He's right there. Oh my gosh. No, not the tree. Oh gosh, dude. Oh, dude, the Yeezys have been ruined.
Hold the opposite way.
What
did you do? Dude.
All right, I'm walking in the water.
Yo, what?
Oh my gosh.
I don't know.
Congratulations, man. That's a stud for a first fish on fly.
Dude, I feel like it's tradition. Like whenever you do something for the first time, it has to be a big fish. Like, Jake got his first one and it was like a 5.5-pounder.
Oh, I have a scale.
Oh, you do?
Yeah,
for the
yeah,
first
yeah.
time ever,
yeah,
we have
yeah.
a scale.
2.5.
There we go, dude. 2-pound, 5-ouncer,
dude,
guys.
Dude, I'm so jealous. How do you fight?
Like, I don't know.
What'd it feel like?
It felt so different. I didn't know how to, because I'm so used to reeling in fish, I didn't know what I was supposed to do.
Just kind of picked it up. It was so soft, too.
Now that I got Blackwell around, we can even do the little John B release, you know? Just copy him real quick.
There she goes. Dude, Black Hole, thanks for teaching me how to fly fish, bro. First ever fly. We only spent $300 to make that happen, guys. Please like and subscribe. Like, he didn't hammer it at all. He was just
sipped it.
Just sipped it and just kept moving. And I was like, what's going on here? And then I was like, yeah. And I remembered not to do this. I remembered to do this. But when I did that, there was so much line out.
When I came running over, you were like,
yeah,
was already.
So that I like forgot I had to keep doing that. And so then I thought I could just pull him like a cane pole in. But he was so far out. And then that's when I jumped in. First fish.
I'm jealous.
Do you want to try it?
Yeah, dude. Of course I want to try it.
Devin. Oh. Devin. Oh, it's huge. Oh, it's. Don't lose him. Don't lose him, Devin. Oh my gosh. God. No way.
Oh, my gosh. Bro. What?
Dude. Holy cow.
Yo.
Guys.
Epic. That's epic.
Dude, look how he ate it, too.
Oh, he swallowed it.
Gosh.
Yo, how was that?
Dude, that was
wild. It was wild, right?
It was just what you said. There was nothing, and I saw my line sinking, and I was like, huh.
Can you guys believe that? That was freaking crazy.
Insane.
Guys, we were just here talking with some subscribers. Like, literally, right after I caught my fish, I was like, okay, we're good. We're done.
Dude, that was nuts.
Dude, I saw your rod going, and I was like, okay, he's got the log. He's got the tree out there.
Dude, you guys both just started today, yeah. And you both caught some studs on fly.
Congrats.
Hey,
it's all thanks to the teacher. Yeah, you know
actually,
what I mean?
Sensei.
Dude, they tore that thing off.
Yeah.
212.
212?
Just had to outdo me real quick. You know? So we're gonna have to get back out here and do some more fly fishing. Unfortunately, our cameras have died. Like, that was last second action, dude. How was the bite?
I was freaking out. What I forgot to do was keep my finger on it, like, as I was stripping. So
I think that's what I did too. My line went everywhere.
So I kept stripping, but it kept, like, pulling it back out, and I was like, no! Yeah, it was a mess.
Freaking tanks. Honestly, bigger than the fish we catch out here on Bass Gear, too. I think they don't realize, like, nobody fly fishes out here, they don't realize that the flies are fake.
Thanks for biting.
Dude.
Peace.
That was crazy, guys. That's gonna do it for today's video. If you guys are not already subscribed, go ahead and subscribe button. Leave a like, comment down below what we should do next, because we're literally willing to do anything. We just went fly fishing and we were terrible at it, but we made it happen. Let's be honest here. I'm good at a very few things in my life, and fly fishing is not one of them. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. Until the next fishing adventure, Fishbowl. I'm out of here.
I just don't want you to look terrible on camera.
Yeah, I feel.
Look at his outfit. He already does, dude.
The Charizard socks are. Dude, they're fire. They're fire.
They're fire type, you know?
God.